registered some 5 million diabetics in 2016, a staggering number that reflects the spread of this chronic disease, making it a large and promising market to diabetes treatment in the Mediterranean. This is attracting big pharmaceutical firms to invest in Algeria as a first step to eventually infiltrate the African market. Lemia Shush reports.
With nearly 5 million diabetics in 2016, Algeria is the largest market for diabetes treatments in the Mediterranean, a selection factor which attracts pharmaceutical companies.
Algeria is one of the most important markets for us in the Mediterranean region. Algeria is competing neck to neck with Turkey. And this is actually, I think actually right now is the biggest in this region. And the only reason is that the government has a policy for healthcare in the country and have been very progressive in putting forward treatment of people with diabetes. Also because we have made a factory early, many years ago, and worked together with the Ministry of Health.
Novo Nordisk, a world leader in diabetes treatment, will invest in the Algerian market by building its fifth production pole, constituting an important gateway to infiltrate the African market.
We have five big production sites. Then we have one in Russia, and then we have one in Algeria at the moment. So if you want to do high quality, big volume, the global standard production of insulin, and you will see that tomorrow, then you don't do it like this. You have to find a safe location. You have to make sure that you have completely sterile environments. You have to educate people in standard operating procedures. The American Food and Drug Administration have to be able to come and inspect it and say, this is perfect. So if we do it, we do it right. We don't just build something in a few months, because we have to supply almost, you know, 500,000 Algerians with insulin from that production site. So it's a serious investment, and you will see.
Yeah, the production lines that Novo Nordisk produce on are the same all over the world. It doesn't matter if they are in Denmark, in US, in France, in Algeria or China. It's the same technology we are using all over the world. It's the same line. So yes, there will be a transfer of technology.
More than 415 million people around the globe suffer from diabetes, a high rate that is not likely to decline in the coming years. The International Diabetes Federation expects more than 250 million diabetics by the year 2040.
If somebody tells me that diabetes will no longer be a problem in the next 25 years, I won't believe it. I think the numbers will increase. What we hope to do is to see to it that the numbers don't increase as much as we think they will increase.
The diabetes market is thus one with great potential and a constant evolution. And pharmaceutical firms are set to make fortunes out of it with the right strategy and marketing.